Kirtan Sadhus Exploring Spiritual Truths was conducted again live today by Balasans of Nityananda Gurukul on Nityananda TV. cenEducation.nityananda.org for more on Nityananda Gurukul.
Just adding a point, what I understand is, like any act, when you do it out of feeling connection, the moment you have that feeling connection itself, master will take care. So even if you do enriching, or even if you fall down to the space of incompletion, still just having that feeling connection is enough. Nothing outside will be able to affect you, because it will be directly master who will be taking care of you. So what I understand is, just having the feeling connection is enough.
See, what I feel is enriching happens when we're so full of Swamiji that we just want to go and tell more and more people about him and enrich more people. So only when we're full of that Swamiji's energy, we want to do Swamiji's mission, that's our first priority. Only when we have that context, we can actually authentically enrich people. So at that point, we'll be full of feeling connection, so we'll just share it with other people.
Daily live Tamil Kapitado program on Ara TV, Yes TV, Tune 6, Krishna and Deepam. Check your local listings. Live Kannada call-in Kapitado on Nakshatra TV, 5:30 to 6 p.m. daily. Lord Kalabhairava Puja happened again today to receive blessings for Nityanandoham 1008 in Phuket. Message to Nityanandoham Chalo on Facebook for your blessings. Monday Nitya Yoga practice was completed again this week in Singapore. Nitya Yoga practice in Singapore was followed by a Third Eye Awakening demonstration by visiting Balasans of Nityananda Gurukul. The Nitya Dhyana Yoga two-day program was conducted this week by the Acharya in Slovakia for 8 participants experiencing the transformation of Guru's energy. This Wednesday's Samyama practice in Singapore was the final before many leave for Nityanandoham in Phuket. The sound Samyama practice was from Yoga Sutra 123, Chapter 3, Verse 17, and was paired with Swamiji's bioenergy meditation. With the most recent Nitya Yoga Detox program concluding last week, we have a look back at the transformative experience of those participants.
My name is Christine. I'm from Melbourne, Australia. I run a few businesses from my home. I'm a mother of 2 kids. For me, the guided meditation sessions made me realise how close I am to this spiritual space and how close I am to Swamiji and to wanting to help other people at all different levels. And it brought out the fun in everybody, because everybody just had transformed to a place that made them lighter and brighter, and we had a lot of fun with the group that we had. We joined in all the cultural festivities that were going on at the same time. We were involved in the processions, we attended the pujas, we went to satsang every day, we got to see Swamiji. There's so many people in this group that found a different part of themselves that they never even knew existed. It actually completes you as a human being from a much deeper level. And whilst you're going through the detox process and wanting to learn and cleanse and do all those things to your body, without having this other aspect of completion, then it doesn't really fulfill you and enrich you as much as it could. One of the other beautiful things as part of the program is the friendships that were formed. We all became a very close group by the end, and actually we'll keep in contact with each other.